Ladies and gentlemen, this opening contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit.
Why do you need a time?
Introducing first, the cup into the ring by his manager, Vernon Envy. Weighing in at 180 pounds, he comes to you from Unity, Maine. He is the Wrestling Revolution,
time of the first match of the month of November 2006. NWH Extreme Style. It's Chase San Antonio in the black and blue, ready to lock it up with the Wrestling Revolution. Cameron Matthews in the green and blue and red and every virtual color of the rainbow. This man's a wonky fashion statement, ladies and gentlemen. Take the scully off and let's wrestle there, little guy. Well, any of you that know the pedigree of Cameron Matthews, he may be small of stature, but this guy is grease lightning in a bottle. This guy can move. This guy is a true mat technician. A man who studies and hones his craft on locking it up with one of the fan favorites here in NWH, the Heartstopper, Chase San Antonio. Time from the center of the ring now, brushing back towards the left side. Cameron Matthews locks in the side headlock. Locking the knee bolts, whip to the far. Oh, shoulder block by Cameron Matthews, blows him a kiss for style and luck. Chase drops low, Chase with the leapfrog. Chase, up the arm, big arm drag, take over by Chase San Antonio. And another, down goes Cameron Matthews. A third exchange, and Matthews finds the backside again, and a fourth, and now grabbing the arm and locking it in by the shoulder socket. And despite the smashing of the bat on that ring apron, Chase San Antonio firmly in control of this one. Cameron backing him into that rear right corner. Chase wants a clean break, but oh, Cameron taking a dirty shot. He misses, nobody home, and the sweeping arm drag takedown again by Chase. Locking it in deep now. Palm of that hand on the shoulder. Locking arm in arm and ripping and tearing away at that shoulder socket. Ligaments, tendons, the rotator cuff, a very delicate area of the human body. A lot of damage, dropped toe hold by Cameron Matthews. The rollover, grapevining the leg, and it looks like a half of an STF submission of some kind, yanking back on the foot for leverage. And at this point now, looking like half of the STF, maybe some kind of reverse side figure four or something. Cameron was twisting that ankle to add measure and leverage there. He wants to make Chase tap. Wrenching in that headlock now. Cameron is smart. He's using his head. If you can ground the bigger opponent, ground the bigger wrestler, take the oxygen from his body. Oh, baby. Wow. What a jawbreaker from Chase San Antone, snapping the chin down across the back of the head. Beautiful maneuver and a very intelligent maneuver from Chase San Antone. And now raking the eyes and pushing him into that front corner here. Referee Pee Wee Hart asserting that count. Cameron doesn't want to break it. He waits to every digit of that four count. And now stomping away to the midsection. Winding up the arm. This could bode to be trouble. Well, now that's disgusting. This is a wrestling event. This is a show of sportsmanship. This is supposed to be an athletic event. Jesus. This guy's turning into a mockery. Winding up the arm now. Oh. Running back through, and all with the leverage he could do is basically flip his body over to take some of the pressure off that socket. It's either flip or get their arm snapped. Backing into those heel ropes, whipping back to far. Cameron misses the clothesline. Oh! Roll-up takeover, getting a one count only. Chase San Antone scrambling back to his feet. Oh, but there's the nice side kick from Cameron Matthews. And he stuck it. He drove it home, driving the elbow right down into the sternum. Matthews for the cover, the one. No, Chase able to kick out. And now Cameron's going to challenge the officiating knowledge of Pee Wee Hart. Going after that left arm now, Chase San Antone. Stomping away with a knee to that joint, now rolling over the arm, putting pressure on it. Oh, baby! Driving the shoulder to shoulder contact right there. That's an innovative move right there from Cameron Matthews. Every time you see this guy in the ring, it's something different. Cameron comes up with something new. And you know what, at his age, Cameron Matthews, I believe, is only 20, 21 years old. This guy has got a brilliant and bright future. And you know, as despicable as he is, as Vernon Envy now, taking that bat for Chase San Antone on the outside as Pee Wee Hart is distracted. Back to what I was saying, Cameron Matthews has got quite the future in this business. This is a young man who has a very cocky attitude, a very bad demeanor, if I may say, but take nothing away from his athletic ability. This guy's all aces when it comes to the wrestling game. Oh! Beautiful slide under the bottom rope, and that might have done more damage to Matthews than it did his opponent. Matthews is reeling after that one. He might have done something to that shoulder.
High flies!
Getting some aid from Vernon Envy. Introducing him to the canvas the hard way. Chase Matt. Matt Chase, how the hell are you? Oh, shot to the midsection by Chase San Antone. As that action is sprawling on the outside of the ring. But wait, no, Vernon Envy. Cameron just slapped Vernon Envy. He just slapped Vernon Envy. Oh, and Envy catches one again, this time from Chase San Antone. Oh, and the face of Envy is as red as the beet. He has been biatch slapped from pillar to post, for lack of a better word. Oh, and a slap to Pee Wee Hart. This is a slap fest. Slap-a-rama. Wow. Now Chase scooping up Cameron Matthews. Oh, and tossing him into the front row, right into the lap of Dr. Nick.
This match is considered a no contest. No contest.
That sucks! That sucks!
take the time to explain something. For the rules of the Maine Athletic Commission, an athlete cannot cross the barrier into the crowd. Therefore, the match is considered a no contest and is thrown out.
The commission